probably look knackered. That's probably because I am. I've ridden all the way from my home in the south, sort of southwest of the UK, of England, right up to the Highlands in Scotland. Actually, it wasn't too bad a journey on a big bike. That's Black Rock Cottage behind me. I come up here to try and to meet up with another YouTuber, Nobby. Step away from the screens. He's riding a tiny little 125 monkey bike around the coastline of Great Britain. I want to try and meet him and ride a little bit of the North Coast 500 with him. He's doing it to raise money for Combat Stress, which is a veterans charity. So I think he's really got his heart into this, and he's really doing some great things. And so to give him my support, I've ridden all the way up here. I still got another 40 miles to ride before I meet him. He's camped up at a place called Speen Bridge, I think. So I'm going to get going now and get to camp. I could do with a hot brew and some food. I'll tell you what, it's not very warm up here. 14 degrees C. It's a bit chilly. My hands are cold. Right, I'm going to get on. Here we are at Glencoe. Got snow up there. What a majestic place. Absolutely fantastic. I rode down this way last time on my North Coast 500 journey, but I didn't have the camera running, and I thought this time I'm not going to miss it. So I stopped back there to put the camera on. But just look at it. One of the most famous glens in the whole of Scotland. Speen Bridge. Apparently the campsite is about 4 miles beyond Speen Bridge. There's Speen Bridge Mill there. So shouldn't be too much longer. That's not bad going, is it? All the way from Swindon to here in one hit. If I'm not mistaken, I think, can I get in there? That's the memorial to the commandos there. Yeah, let's take a look at the commandos memorial. I don't know much about it. I think it was put here because the commandos used to train a lot in this area. Look at this, look, running after a 400 mile journey. There they are. The Commandos Memorial. God. They're looking toward these hills here. So I guess that's where they did their training. The rainbow. Oh, wonderful. Shame I can't get up to it though. They've got fencing all the way around it. Look at that. Right. Let's get back to the bike. One last look. Commandos Memorial. Well, I wanted an adventure, I certainly got one. I'm not sure where he is. I don't know if he's down here. I don't know if I'm going the wrong way. I can't quite find him on my sat-nav. So I'm going to go along here for about a mile, and then if not, turn around and go back. Find somewhere to camp and start afresh in the morning. Excuse me, no wild camping permitted. How are you? I wasn't sure if you was here because I was trying to put it onto my sat nav. You've been kipping, have you? Well, good morning everybody, just woke up. This is the I guess the second day, the first camp. This is the remains of the first camp. This has got a decamp, pitch the tents down, and then I'll be following Nobby, and he's riding this monkey bike equivalent. I'm not sure what it was. I think it's called a Honda Chally clone, I think. He's currently in his tent getting himself ready for the day, I think. Are you still alive, Nobby?
Hiya!
Hey, that, you're not Teapot One, are you?
I'm sitting coming to a shitty puss. How you doing?
I'm alright, yeah. Good night.
Yeah, slept like a log. It was
no,
good.
No midges?
Not too many in me tent, I don't think.
No. Right, that's it. That's where we were. Nothing left behind. Leaving this lovely place. This is our first campsite. Hopefully it'll only get better from now on. I'll follow you.
Thank you very much, sir. I've just got to warm her up for a couple of minutes.
Yeah, same here. Just come off the main road. We saw this viewing area, and just stopped to take a look at the view. It's a fantastic view, and in the distance is Loch Mary. You can just see it just down there. But I just mentioned to Lee, I told Lee something about a bit of personal history, family history, or if you call it history. But I got to say it now because I told him. It looks like if all goes to plan, all goes well, that I should be a grandfather. I should be a grandfather around about December time. So that's the first grandchild. So yeah, maybe I'm becoming old. I don't know. What do you reckon? Am I getting old, Nobby?
Oh, I don't know about getting anything, Sam.
Just what you are, aren't you?
You are what you are, mate.
You are what you are, yeah.
You are only nearly 60 in laps around the sun.
Yeah, that's right. I don't mind being a granddad. Well, I'm happy to be a granddad, actually. But I don't mind getting old, so long as I can keep having adventures, keep riding my bike and keep doing stuff.
My old man used to say to me, mate, if you could do it yesterday, you could do it today. If you can do it today, you can do it tomorrow.
Yeah, I'll live by that. Nice one.
No worries. He's dead, by the way.
Yeah, but he was a good bloke, that's the main thing.
Yeah, he was a good bloke.
Well, we just stopped back there for the pictures and the viewpoint of Lock Murray, that's it. This is just on the road down now, look. What fantastic roads to ride in Scotland. That's fantastic. The rain's coming down a little bit now, but we've had to stop. Not because of the rain though, but because Nobby's bike, he's got to refuel it. He's only got a small tank. I think, how much does it hold? What, how much?
A 3.5 litre tank.
3.5 litre tank, so that gives you about 70 miles, doesn't it? It gives
me 60-65 until the reserve kicks in. I've got about 20 in the reserve.
So you've got 65 miles till the reserve kicks in, and you've got 20 on reserve. So his reserve just kicked in a few miles back, so now we've got to stop. He's got to take everything off so he can lift the seat, access the fuel tank, and then refuel. But he's got someone put these brackets on, so he's carrying, what are these, 5 litres each? So he's got a spare 10 litres, one this side, one the other side.
300 miles of fuel.
And he reckons 300 miles. That's not bad, is it, on a fill-in? Well, we just stopped at the Gairlock Museum and Cafe for a coffee and cake, as you do. And now we're on our way towards Ullapool. The sign says it, welcome to Ullapool. And my friend Lorraine, she says there's a lovely fish and chip shop in here, and we're going to stop and get some of the best fish and chips in the whole of Scotland. That's what Lorraine says, the best fish and chips. Say again.
I just wanted to say thank you for being a legend and making your way out to see us, Sandy. It means a lot, mate. It genuinely does. Don't forget to engrave my name on that knife.
Anyone that's wondering, this is what I bought myself. A haddock wrap. Beautiful fish. Absolutely beautiful. Well cooked. I'm looking forward to getting that. Well, that was a very nice break at the harbour side in Ullapool, and now we're on for the afternoon leg. What's the time now? 3:20. We'll be looking for somewhere to camp in about 3 hours, I expect. Look at the lovely mountains over there then. That's fantastic, isn't it? This is a place known as Knockin Crag. Apparently there's a nature reserve close by. Well, we're just riding through a place known as Ullapool. Sounds like Ullapool, but it's with an N. There, you can see it there, and a poor house. Well, just round the corner, there's a fantastic bridge known as the Kailescu Bridge. It's a modern bridge, but it's very imposing in its structure, its design and architecture. So hopefully, if the GoPro keeps recording, you'll get to see that. And if the conditions permit, I might fly the drone. We'll certainly get the other camera out as well. Well, here's that fantastic bridge. We're going across it now. Best perspective though is from the car park over there. We're right at the very top almost now, not far away from Durness, maybe a dozen miles away from Durness. Very open, beautiful landscape up here. What I have noticed is the camaraderie amongst the smaller bikers seems to be very strong. Well, I managed to reach camp again, the second camp of the trip. We've just gone probably about 10 miles past Durness on the way to John O'Groats now. So this is my pitch in the MSR Elixir 2. I did set my camera up, but I've done a panoramic shot. So I'll put that in if it's any good. Hopefully it'll be all right. And we were riding along this road here and getting a little bit desperate because finding campsites was a bit difficult. And then Nobby spotted this track and I was a bit concerned about getting the big bike in because fully loaded with a tank of fuel, panniers and camping kit on it, you're probably looking at about 260 kilos there. So it's not a light bike, but managed to get it in. I walked in first, tested it, made sure the ground was soft enough, was able to get the bike in, and then turned it round so it's facing out for tomorrow morning, so I should get out of here easy. I put a stone under the side stand to prop it up, and it's not sinking, so we're good there. Of course, Nobby with his little bike, he gets that in. God, flip your neck. How the hell does he do it? I don't know.
I'm regretting it.
How do you jump around like that?
I'm regretting it.
Oh, crikey. Anyway, his little bike, it's so manageable. So manageable. I know the big bike's a very capable machine, but when you boil it down to practicalities, these little bikes, they got a lot going for them, you know?
You've got small bike envy.
I have. And one other thing I noticed also, the big adventure bikes, they're becoming a bit ubiquitous. There's lots of them around. And we saw a lot of them today, and I'd say probably 50% of them would wave at you, 50% would ignore you. But the little bikes and the attraction and the friendliness and the camaraderie and the whatever it isness that these little bikes do, they're a real friendly bunch.
We're just nicer people, Sandy, is all it is.
Yeah. I'll tell you what, if I ever get a third motorcycle...
When, yeah.
I'd love to get myself one of them little Honda CT125s or something similar to that. I'm seriously considering it, maybe next year. I'll have to see. That's Nobby's setup anyway, he's set up in his nature hike there. So, it's been fantastic. We'll make John O'Groats tomorrow, no problem. I reckon we'll get there mid-morning. And then I'm debating whether to go off and do my own thing or whether to ride on down through Scotland on the east coast, get out of Scotland and then jet off home then, and leave Nobby to his own devices for the rest of the journey.
Whatever you choose, dude.
I think he'll manage okay. Anyway, I'm going to get myself set up now for the evening's camp. I don't know how well this camera shows it, but That's the view out of the tent there. But anyway, the stove I'm using on this particular expedition is the remote canister stove called the MSR Windmaster. I'm using a Titan kettle, so I'm going to get mine evening grub on the go. I've got noodles, fresh fruit, and all sorts of nice goodies. Let's light the stove. Yeah, I'm liking that setup. That stove will work in all weathers. You can invert the canister, it's got a preheater, so when it gets cold, not that it will for another few months yet, but be a good winter stove that. I'm afraid the weather's taken a turn for the worst, and it's got cold, it's raining. I'm gonna have to put on my gloves, my other winter gloves to keep me warmer, and I can't actuate the camera with those, so I'll only be filming highlights when we stop, I think. I'll put this camera away now and I'll bring you back when there's something worth seeing, when I'm able to actuate the camera. Just one last final view of our campsite. Just got some rubbish to pick up and then we're on our way. There's Nobby getting himself ready, but it is very wet this morning. Well, I'm glad to say the weather has warmed up a little bit and the rain has stopped, so I've got my lightweight gloves on again. I'm able now to operate the camera safely. And we're riding across the far north top part of Scotland now, with about 62 miles to go before we get the Jolly Groats. We've got another road blockage going on, look. Stubborn old cow in the road, look. I can just about make out in the distance, right on the horizon over the sea there, the Orkney Islands. So this, we're just coming into Strathy now. Well, we're now in Caithness, and just across there, you can't see it. This village is called Ray, R-A-E-Y, and across there is Dunray Power Station. And then that way is John O'Groats, but Nobby's run out of fuel, so he's got to go through the palaver of taking all of his pack off. All of this has got to come off, lifts his seat up, and then he refuels it. So yeah, I mean, he's not chose the most convenient bike to do this long distance trip on, but it is somewhat of a challenge. Right, just stopping here because I need a pee, but also you can see Dunray, look, there it is, look. There's a convenient wall, there's the power station. I'll let you look at that whilst I do something else. Well, we're currently in Thurso, just waiting for the lights to change. I think the next stop, pretty much Donna Groats. Come on. Next stop, John O'Groats, Nobby, I think. Yes. Not far now. This is the little village of Dunnet, and there's a another little road to the left shortly, which takes you to a place called Dunnet Head. And that is the most northerly point you can get to on the mainland UK. Anyway, the next port of call is John O'Groats. Well, he's triumphantly, Nobby is triumphantly arriving at John O'Groats, which is the turning point for this trip for him, because from here it's all heading south down the east coast of the UK back home. Another 7 days on the road for Nobby. I'll be staying with him for one more day, and then I'll be taking the fast road back to Wiltshire. Well done, Nobby. Legend. Not a leg end anymore. I think you've got to go back out and around. Hey, I just told my viewers, you're not a leg end anymore. You're a bloody legend. Let's go round and get down there.
There he is, look, he's made it.
Can you take a couple of steps for me, Sandy?
I am doing, certainly will. Well done, Nobby.
Thank you very much, sir.
Right, go ahead.
2,000 miles down, and another couple to go.
Well done, mate.
Thank you, dude. Could you snap a couple on there for us?
Well, we're riding now with the North Sea on our left, and we're riding down a few miles to a place called Kinloss. I say a few miles, it's about 140 miles away, where Nobby's going to meet up with one of his friends from his army days, and then we're going to get a camp in the garden there. And I think from that point on the next day, I think I'm off on my way back home down south, and then Nobby will obviously be continuing his journey along the coastline for another 7 days till he gets back to Portsmouth. We've had some pretty bad weather just recently. We've just got through the bad weather now, and the sun's coming out, and hopefully the warm breeze will dry our clothes off. So yeah, been very mixed weather these last few days up in Scotland.
So what
are you doing there, Nobby?
I'm just going to drop the oil, and
you're doing an oil change.
Yep, basically.
Yeah.
Sorry.
Yeah. So anyway, what's happened to bring you up to date? This is the last entry in this video. We've arrived at a place near Kinloss, where one of Nobby's friends from his army days. So I shan't show anything as to exactly where we are, but he's going to do his oil change, service his bike. We're camping in the back garden, and then tomorrow I'm off on my way back home again. So this is the end of the video. So don't forget to keep following Nobby. He's got another 7 days on the road. He should make it back in about a week's time to Portsmouth, and then he'll be across to the other way.
That's it.
I'm on the way home now. I'm leaving Nobby. There he is, look. Nobby. And there's Nobby's mate.
Jake.
Peg leg, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah. Thanks very much for hospitality last night.
No problem, Sunday.
That was, make sure you're in the picture.
You're welcome. Yeah.
That was really, really fantastic. We had he's got a bar in there. He's got all the cooking facilities. But anyway, it was just fantastic. Really had a good time. I got 526 miles.
Jesus.
500 in one hit. But it's on the fast roads, isn't it? And I'm going to get out of second gear for a change.
You know it. I can't thank you enough, mate.
Now I get the white hand.
Really, Nobby. Can't thank you enough, dude.
Success, mate.
Thank you.
Remember, the name for success is
a sheeter.
Yeah. Don't call your bike a sheeter, whatever you do.
It might look like a toilet. But...
Thanks for watching, everybody, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye for now.
Ta-da!
Oh. Don't forget, follow Nobby, link in the description.